This is Roosevelt with AutoNetwork, and I'm going to give you a detailed walk around of this 2014 Hyundai Equus, the ultimate model. This model has a 5-liter V8 that delivers 429 horsepower with premium fuel and 421 horsepower with regular fuel. The exterior color is a white satin pearl. Interior is saddle on saddle. This model gets 15 miles per gallon in the city, 23 miles per gallon on the highway, 18 combined, and has an MSRP of $68,920. And it also has an 8-speed automatic transmission. Now, what's in the ultimate package to make this the ultimate? Well, it has full 12.3-inch LCD instrument cluster display. It has a heads-up display. It has a multi-view camera system, has a forward-view cornering camera, rear seat entertainment system with dual 9.2-inch monitors, four-way power lumbar rear outboard seats, cooled rear seats, rear seat power up and down head restraints with a manual tilt, rear seat illuminated vanity mirrors, a power trunk lid, power rear side window shades, power door closure, and a steering wheel haptic dial control. So, let's go outside, take a detailed walk around of this 2014 Hyundai Equus Ultimate. I'm all right. Yeah, I'm just taping it. I'm taping it. This is Roosevelt with AutoNetwork. I want to talk to you about one of my favorite options in a car. It's called adaptive cruise control, and I'm currently driving a 2014 Hyundai Equus. This model has adaptive cruise, and what it does is not only can you set the cruising speed that you would like to maintain on the highway, you can also set the distance before the brake kicks in on the cruise, meaning the distance between you and the car in front of you. Now, what adaptive cruise does is it allows you to maintain a distance between the car in front of you at a safe speed. As a matter of fact, it actually matches the speed of the car in front of you. And then once you safely change lanes, I can't change lanes here because there are some other cars coming up on the side. And with this car, it has a blind spot warning as well. It's showing in a heads-up display. I don't know whether you can make out the heads-up display here, but right now my speed is at 63, even though I set the cruise at 74. So when I change lanes, what'll happen is the cruise control will resume the 74 speed limit if the car in front of me is going at least 74 or greater. Here I'm getting the blind spot warning notice that a car is coming up beside me. You can see this SUV here that just pulled up. And it also let me know that I had my signal on, and that shouldn't have been. But right now with adaptive cruise, we're back at 74. You can set the distance, whether you want to approach the car and have and get close to the car before the braking occurs, like what's happening now, or you can set it at a farther distance from the car in front of you before the car with the that you're driving that has adaptive cruise kicks in. So this is Roosevelt with Auto Network. Little background and on how adaptive cruise. Now, what are some of the benefits of adaptive cruise? Well, one, it will reduce the stress of driving, which means you don't have to worry about braking and then hitting the resume button on the cruise to resume the speed. It automatically resumes, it brakes for you. It reduces the stress on your leg. You don't have to hit the brake. You don't have to constantly hit the brake, go back and forth from brake to accelerator. And it's also a lot safer than your regular cruise control. It will adjust faster than you can. You may not be paying attention, even though you should be paying attention when you're driving, but somebody may cut in front of you. This car will automatically brake so that you don't hit that car that cuts in front of you. Those are just some of the benefits of adaptive cruise control.